I found something for you guys today, which is a real treat, and I'm frankly surprised that it exists. Now let's take a look at your free Midjourney and how easy it is to get started right now. I'm talking about really, really free, like actually free, and it's high quality and they have Flux. It's just amazing. You don't have to install anything, no paying for anything, and it's unbelievable, but there are no credits or no limited generation or anything like that. Unlimited generation for absolutely free with amazing quality and the ability to use Flux and a bunch of other cool features and AI tools that you only see in paid platforms or complex, comfy UI workflows. You might have seen sites like Playground AI, Leonardo AI, and even Microsoft Bing Create and other sites that are free, but they normally have credits that you have to use up. But this site is free. Like, I'm actually shocked how good the site is, and there doesn't seem to be a catch or a limit. So I'm gonna call this the free Midjourney. I don't even know why I make comfy UI tutorials anymore. So the pictures you're looking at are from a site called PicLumen, and this is how easy it is to get started. You click on sign in with Google, and you're in. Just launch the app and start making some beautiful pictures. Let's take a look at some of the images that other people have created with this tool. First, let's take a closer look at images created by other users. Once you click on the launch app, you'll have the explore button right here, and you can see all the images created by the community that are not private. And let's take a look at this one right here. And as you can see, this is a beautiful image, and it's not just the girl itself. It's just the details of her negligee, her face, my goodness, the eyes. Perfect. The hair reflecting with the light, the curls in her hair and the butterflies. I mean, it's just an amazing picture. And if you want to make a similar image, you can just go ahead and click on remix and I'll throw it into your creator here and you can just click generate. All right, let's take a look at this cute anthropomorphic mushroom, and man, it's a pretty cool, funny image. I really like it. It has that kind of miniature photography where it seems like something's a lot bigger than it should be. I'm not sure if I said that backwards, but basically it looks like a small object up close, but very cute and very alive, and it just kind of represents an entire story, and there's a lot of details here that they got right. Very cute picture. Okay, and here's a cyberpunk one, and I think this one's done well with the shininess of her jacket and very futuristic, very cool style. Very good picture. Now we have one with very intricate detail and everything from the light kind of going through her ear where the translucent part of the cartilage is and the little details on this, I don't know what it's called, the thing on her face and then her earrings and her necklace here, whatever this is called, an ascot, I'm not sure. A necklace, let's just call it that. A very intricate detail, very beautiful negligee and design, even the background design. The horns and her skin, she has that alabaster skin, just beautiful, beautiful picture. And a theme that I see in most of these pictures is the accurate lighting. You see the lighting coming from above here, shining down on her horns, her head, and you'll see that some parts of her face are actually darker right here, and then it gets lighter again on her chest. Really makes the picture feel realistic. So those are some of the pictures that are created by the community. Let's create our own by clicking on the create button right here. And I created a few pictures myself already, and you look at these pictures that I generated. Man, beautiful pictures, first try. You look at this one right here. This one was a remix of someone else's picture. Picture that turned out pretty nice. Now this one looks pretty cool as well. Let's do some inpainting. Over here you got some options. Click on inpaint and click on her forehead because this doesn't make sense. And we're just gonna erase the thing on her forehead. And there we go. That easy. And here's some other pictures I created, and this is nice. Like, this was just, I put in one sentence and used the prompt enhancer and it gave me that. Even with a short prompt like this one, it was just less than a sentence. I got this, which is really, really nice. And it was exactly what I was going for. The models also do very well with spelling. If you see here, free Midjourney, and this is actually better than what Midjourney can actually spell. I haven't checked it lately, but in the last 3 weeks I checked it and it seems that this is more consistent, especially with the Flux model. Flux is very good at spelling. So you see here, 3 out of 4 was pretty good. Midjourney, free Midjourney, free Midjourney, free Midjourney. Pretty close though. Same here, it's almost like 3 out of 4, free Midjourney, free Midjourney, free Midjourney. Pretty close. Then it's he, free Midjourney. Maybe it's because she's Japanese. That's unfortunate. I like this one the best in terms of art style of the face here. Alrighty, so now let's make a thumbnail for this video. I'm gonna go for a cyberpunk theme and I'm gonna use the Flux generator, which is hot right now. Keep in mind, this is Flux Snail, so it's not Flux Dev. So the results won't be as good as Flux Dev, but you can use these for commercial use. Something cool to point out is this nice feature here, which is the auto translate button. If you don't speak English, you can type in your native language and you can click translate. And voila, there's the English and you can use that in your prompt. And this is important since the prompt only understands English. This is a great addition that opens it up to so many more people. Also, there's this prompt enhanced feature right here, which makes your prompt more interesting with the click of a button, which is a feature that Leonardo AI has, but you needed to be on the paid plan and you need to waste some credits to do that. And then they have this button right here, which gives you the ability to mess with the seed, CFG scale, steps, and even add a negative prompt, which is the stuff that you don't want in your picture. Up here is a ratio button, so you can set if you want it landscape or portrait. I'm going to do a 16:9 since this is a thumbnail. Then you could choose how many pictures you want to generate at once. Man, it's free and you could generate 4 pictures at once. There has to be a catch, right? I haven't seen it yet. You also have a choice of a couple of models, which is realistic, anime, line art, or Flux Schnell. And this tool is just wow because all of these generate some really good pictures. By the way, on the left of the prompt, if you click on this little JPEG or this image right here icon, it'll actually give you an option to choose a file or drop it in here so you can upload an image and do image to image. Another really cool thing they have with the image to image is if you click on this and then go here to content reference, there's also a style and character reference. So these are like IP adapters. So if I clicked on style reference, it'll take all the different elements of cyberpunk. And if I clicked on character reference, it'll be more like a consistent character and try to get this character's face in the picture. All right, so let's go ahead and try something here. I'm going to do some cyberpunk picture and type this up here. Now I'm going to use the prompt enhance and then click this. And then boom goes the dynamite. And that looks amazing. Now, once you generate a picture, you can click on the ellipse here and you have more options. You can do a remix, remove a background with a single click, or you can inpaint something like this. Now, if you hover over the picture again, you'll see this little button here that will allow you to upscale. And this is very cool because you can actually increase the redraw strength, which is kind of like a slight creative upscale that allows you to recreate finer details in the picture, similar to Magnific AI, but not as strong and not as capable, but still pretty cool. It's more for refining and adding specific detail rather than Magnific AI, which creates new details. Which this will do, but not to that extent. Now, if you click on the picture and you get it full screen, you'll see that you'll have all those options here on the right and you'll have more room to work and you can do all those options from here. And there's even a button down here to link it directly to your social media and go immediate to all your stuff like Facebook, Twitter, or whatever you're into. So I like that they do that because that's really necessary to get your tool out there. Now let's take a look at some of the frequently asked questions that are very important. Now the first one is, can we use this for commercial purposes? And it says yes, but with the caveat. And it gives you the standard answer about commercial generation rights and you can actually sell your image. You can't sell other people's pictures, but they're also not liable if you do sell it and get sued. So you could sell it. But unlike with Adobe Firefly and DALL-E 3, they're not going to protect you if you get into a lawsuit. So the standard answer there is don't create anything that's too close to something related to Disney, especially Disney, or something that's an actual IP, and you should be okay. Should is the key word here. Now the next and most important FAQ, which I had to go check, is Lumen AI image generator free to use? And the answer is yes, and there's no subs, there's no credits required, which is, man, that's amazing. Use everything for free, which is absolutely amazing and unbelievable in my opinion. I'm sure over time when they've collected enough data and the user has been adjusting their weights for their models long enough, they will start charging. But right now, and probably for the next couple months or year, it's going to be absolutely free. And there's not even an upgrade or anything you can buy. There's no credits. There's nothing. It's just free and it creates amazing art. And I don't really see a need to go to Midjourney. So I got high hopes for this tool and it's already exceeded expectations. All right, so let's dive into this further and see what else you can do. All right, so let's see this right here. And these are your features. You have the AI image generator, which we just looked at. You got text to image, you got image to image. You got the Flux AI image generator, which I just used. You got AI replace, which is very, very cool. I'll show you in a second. And an AI image extender, which is like outpainting, but cooler. So you remember when I said AI replace is cool? Well, let's see what that does. So there's actually a tutorial link here, which is very cool for this free site to do. So right here, this first one has information about the AI replacer and some tutorials on it. And over here, it tells you what it can do. And there's a lot of things that you can do actually. And the first one here is a type of inpainting where you mask out the section where you want to inpaint something and then you type it in and then you get that object there. So in here, they took a blank field and turned it into a field of flowers, which is So amazing. Now in this next one, they took a dull sky, an overcast sky, and turned it into a sunset. So they masked out the sky and they turned it into a sunset, which is so amazing because I just had a realtor take pictures of my house and they were all overcast skies. And I was just like, why don't you use AI to like change the sky? I mean, as long as you don't change the house, just change the sky, make it a beautiful sunset, and people would want to buy the house more. So I changed the pictures myself. Now in this scenario, it's actually an image to image, but it was just asking the AI to swap the regular eggs for painted eggs, and it did it. It even added a balloon in the back, which is pretty amazing. Kept everything else the same. Now it's just changing specific colors, and so it changed the umbrella here from blue to red. And that's pretty amazing that it's that focused and it's that coherent to just change one little thing. Same with the eggs. That's pretty cool. And it even does face swap with the image to image. So this is a very streamlined tool where you can do multiple different tasks with a single image to image slash AI replace. Even give you some advanced tips and like just, I mean, this is too good to be true. Everything's free and then they give you like tutorials. No other site that even Midjourney, the paid site, didn't do this. I mean, they had Discord and you had to like figure out the prompting. They had like some channel where you had to read through the code and figure it out. But this site really holds your hand and they put a lot of work and effort into this. There's multiple tutorials that are very detailed and show you how to make the most of this site. So that's pretty amazing. So if I were to do a review on this site, it is a 10 out of 10. I mean, the ease of use. I mean, it doesn't have the complexity that you would have like with some art generators like Comfy, but it does an amazing job, especially with the Chanel model and also their custom model that they have. And this thing generates some beautiful art. I mean, look at this. You see the lighting through her ear. So the translucent part of the ear and then the light's just going through it. And you see it shining in her hair as well as her horns. And look at all the detail in this and her necklace and the negligee. Everything is just perfect. And this was made with a realistic model, which they even have this little light mode and dark mode button. It's just a pretty amazing tool. So this is PicLumen. And I recommend that you go try it out today and see if it's amazing as I said it was. And I guarantee you, you'll be making pictures like this in seconds. It is an amazing tool and I can't believe it's free. So here is your free Midjourney and you're welcome. Go ahead and check it out right now for free, unlimited with no catch. Anyways, if you like this video or if you found it useful, go ahead and click the thumbs up button and give this video a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more tools like this and you like AI stuff, go ahead and subscribe and check out the channel. So go ahead and have fun with these models and try it out right now, right now, right now. Oh yeah, if you want to learn how to create AI videos that are 6 seconds long, that are the best AI videos that you've seen around as easy as using this site, go ahead and check out this link right here. And if you want to learn how to install Comfy AI, check out this video over there. Thanks again, and don't forget to like the video. Bye.